Welcome to this live broadcast for Learn English Lessons. I'm Sally and I'm here today with Kirk, who's here to tell you a little bit about himself and then about Learn English Lessons. Over to you, Kirk.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming today. So I am a teacher at the British Council in Barcelona, and I also work on the Learn English websites. And lately, we've been doing a lot of work on our Learn English Lessons, which is one of the resources available to our subscribers. Every month, we release a new lesson, and each lesson has a different topic. This month, the topic is free time and leisure, and so that's what we're here to talk about today.
Okay, brilliant. Thanks, Kirk. As Kirk said, he's in Barcelona, and in fact, we're both at opposite ends of Barcelona, and we'd love to know where you're joining us from today. So please tell us hi in the comments and tell us where you are in the world. Kirk, what's in today's lesson plan?
Well, first we'll begin with a short conversation about free time and leisure and hobbies. Then we will look at six phrasal verbs that people often use to talk about free time and hobbies. Then we'll have some time for questions and answers, and then we'll finish up with a short quiz.
Okay, brilliant. I'm just looking at all the hellos that are coming in. We've got hellos coming in from all over the world. So I just want to say hello back to a few people. So hello to people in Bangladesh, Sudan, Pakistan. I made a quick list. Senegal. They're just coming in so quickly now. So fantastic. Thanks for joining us. And Brazil as well. Thanks for joining us. Great to have you here. So if you've just joined, this is our live broadcast for Learn English Lessons. And our topic today is... Kirk?
Free time and leisure.
Good, glad you remembered that. And we're going to talk about that topic now, and we're going to put some questions on the screen, and we'd love you to join in. Mm. So if you want to write your answers in, please do. What do you do in your free time? What do you like doing in your free time, Kirk?
Well, what I really like to do is go hiking. There's just lots of beautiful places really, really close to Barcelona. But, you know, it's difficult to find the time sometimes, but that's what I really like to do.
Yeah.
What about you, Sally?
In my free time, like you say, there's not that much free time these days. But what I really like doing is painting and sketching. Hmm. And I used to go swimming, but I don't do that so much these days. Please tell us your answers in the comments. I can see lots more hellos coming in. So hello back to Algeria, Alicante, Myanmar, Australia, Vietnam, all over the world. Great to have you here. So what do you do with your friends? Do you go out with friends these days, Kirk?
Well, no, I haven't been out with my friends for a while, unfortunately, just because of the restrictions, but I'm really looking forward to doing that, hopefully soon. We do talk online or on the phone pretty often though. So that's been nice to reconnect with some friends who I don't usually speak with as much, actually.
Yeah. Things are different these days, aren't they? Mm. So listening to music. Xiaomin likes listening to music. Oh, that's great. And I love your little notes that you've put at the end there. And Latifa says, I like reading stories in my free time. Oh, that's good. And I wonder if you read them in English or which language do you read in, Latifa? Okay. I like watching TV series, says Fernando.
Me too.
Yeah, me too. I think we're all... Anyone who watches TV is probably watching more than they used to these days. And Ram, I used to play cricket in my free time. Oh. Okay. Yeah. Cricket must be good fun. I mean, I guess we all used to do things that we don't do anymore.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. Though I've found myself taking up some old hobbies as well that, you know, I used to I didn't have time to do some of these things. So like recently I've got into woodworking, which is something I used to do, and I can do, have more time to do it. So
that's a new hobby that you've taken up?
No, really, it's an old one. I've just got into it. I wouldn't say I've taken up any new hobbies, because I have quite a few. So.
Okay. But if you, anyone who's watching, if you've taken up any new hobbies, tell us what they are. We'd love to know. Okay, so Catherine says, I rarely have free time, but if I do, I love playing video games and reading books sometimes. Okay. Which video games do you like playing? That'd be good to know. Tran says, how's the weather? What's the weather like? I'm gonna change his question a bit. What's the weather like? What's the weather like there, Kirk?
Well, we've got clouds basically today. There's a little bit of sun out there, but it's not raining like it was yesterday. And it's fairly warm for Barcelona.
Well, in my side, I mean, I know we're at different ends of Barcelona, aren't we? You're more out in the countryside. It's actually sunny here in the center of Barcelona.
Oh, okay. Not up here. with that cloud.
Oh, Magda does crochet and handicrafts. Great. Oh, that's cool. I wonder what you crochet. That's something that I used to do. I'll tell you what I've taken up is power walking at home.
At home?
Yeah.
How do you do that then?
I just watched a video. It's a series of videos by a woman called Leslie. Can't remember her surname, but she's amazing. And it's just at home in the living room, and it's a total workout. It's not just walking. It's for your arms and for your core muscles and everything. It's fantastic.
Wow. Well, I never heard of that. That sounds interesting.
Thanks for all your answers. I'm playing piano and drawing, walking, great. Watching the news. I like watching American series, says Nasira. I like shopping with my friends. Oh, that's great, Sira. If you can go out. I mean, we can't all go out, can we, these days? What have we got coming up next? Embroidery. Very good.
Great. Well, I wanted to tell all of you about 6 phrasal verbs that people often use to talk about free time and hobbies. So maybe we'll begin with that. But before I tell you about these 6 phrasal verbs, just to make sure we're all on the same page, what exactly is a phrasal verb? I wanted to talk about that for a moment. So a phrasal verb is a kind of verb that has 2 parts, a verb and a particle. Now, a particle is a word like in or out or up or down. There are lots of different particles that we use with phrasal verbs. The important thing is that together these 2 words have a meaning that isn't obvious. It's a meaning that's different from what the words mean when they're alone. And this is what makes phrasal verbs difficult. So we are going to look at, I'm gonna ask you some questions where you need to use a phrasal verb, and that where the question uses a phrasal verb. And what I'd like you to try to do is to figure out what the phrasal verbs are, right? 6 phrasal verbs. So we'll begin with the first one now. As you can see, right, have you any new hobbies recently? So this is a phrasal verb that means to begin doing a new activity. Right? In this case, it would be a new hobby. So have any of you any new hobbies recently? This is a phrasal verb that Sally used, actually, and when we were speaking. Just looking in the comments here. And well, I'm gonna tell you the phrasal verb. Let's see if, there we go, they're coming in. Very good, take up, all right? In this case, it's taken up. Have you taken up any new hobbies recently? Excellent. So the second phrasal verb I wanted to tell you about, very good. Thank you all for your answers. The second phrasal verb, you can see the question here. What have you recently. This is a phrasal verb that means to become interested in. So here you can see someone who got interested in knitting, for example, in the picture there. The question, what have you recently? Let's see. Does anyone have any idea what this one could be? Given up. Got into is the phrasal verb that I was thinking of here. So very good. All right. To get into something is to become interested in something. So what have you got into recently? Let us know what you've got into recently. I mentioned that I have got into woodworking recently. I'm sure all of you have got into different things as well. Okay. So that was we've looked at take up, get into, and now we'll move on to our third phrasal verb. You can see the question here. How do you keep fit? Do you, it's a phrasal verb that means to exercise. Let's see if any of you can guess this phrasal verb. Actually, I can give you another hint. We use this phrasal verb to talk about math as well. It means to calculate. Very good. I see lots of answers there. Work out, and that is correct, right? Do you work out, or how do you work out? Let us know, actually, how all of you work out, how all of you get exercise. I actually could use some inspiration. So, lots of answers coming in there. Thank you very much, everyone. Okay, so we saw take up, get into, we've just looked at work out, and the fourth phrasal verb that I wanted to talk about, you can see the question here, how often do you, and where do you go? This was something Sally and I mentioned, actually, how we haven't been able to do this with our friends recently because of the restrictions. Wondering if any of you can guess what this phrasal verb is here. It's one that we use it means to leave home. And usually we use it when we're talking about having fun, doing something to have fun, like meeting up with friends. Excellent. I see lots of you have guessed the word or identified the word here. It's go out, the phrasal verb. How often do you go out and where do you go? Let us know, please, where you go, what you do when you go out. All right, so we are going to move on to our fifth phrasal verb now. Here, you can see the question, where do you like to with friends? This is a phrasal verb that we use. Well, it means to spend time with people. It can also mean to spend time in a particular place. A lot of people in Barcelona, for example, do this at the beach. They go with their friends or family to relax and enjoy the weather, enjoy the sea. And very good. I see lots of you have identified this phrasal verb as well. It's to hang out, right? So where do you like to hang out with friends? Hang out means to spend time in a place or with people. All right, we are down to our sixth and final phrasal verb. And this is one that we use to talk about learning. It means to learn by listening or learn by watching. So you can see the question here, which is, have you any new vocabulary lately? From where? Let's see if any of you can identify this phrasal verb. I can give you an example. We mentioned that we've been watching lots of TV lately. I think a lot of people have. And I've been watching, very good. Jessica has answered, pick up. And that is the verb here. I was going to explain that I've been watching lots of TV series and films from Denmark. And by watching them, I've picked up some Danish words, some words in the Danish language that I don't know at all, but very good. So pick up means to learn by watching or listening. Let us know if you've picked up any new vocabulary. I'm hoping you've picked up some new phrasal verbs from our chat today. So let's move on. Sally, I think we're down.
I'm back.
Yes.
Kirk, that's amazing that you've picked up Danish from watching TV.
A few words of Danish. I wish I could say I picked up Danish.
Thank you, everyone, for all your answers. I can see just loads and loads of correct answers there. Next time, we're going to have to make this more difficult, Kirk.
I think you're right. Yeah, everyone really didn't expect that. So good work.
So we've been talking about hobbies. No, we've been talking about hobbies. We've also been talking about phrasal verbs. I'm just going to summarize the phrasal verbs that we've talked about here. So Kirk talked about six phrasal verbs, and they are, see if you can, I was going to say, can you remember as well, people who are watching, but we've got them on the screen, which is fantastic. So we've got take up, get into, work out, go out, hang out, and pick up. Okay, so we hope those are useful, and we hope they've helped you. We hope that Kirk's helped you put those into context. We're going to come back to phrasal verbs a bit later, but on the topic of free time and free time activities and hobbies, obviously we can't all do what we used to do because of various restrictions. But Kirk, is there anything that you would really like to do if you had the chance, a new kind of hobby, like, I don't know, hang gliding, for example?
Hang gliding? No, I'd like to think that I would go hang gliding, but I don't think I would. I'd be a little afraid to do that. I would like, for a long time, I've wanted to learn to sail. So I'm hoping I can do that sometime in the next year or so.
Nice, try that out. Okay.
We'll see.
Okay. That's cool. We're going to put some questions on the screen now about hobbies and free time, and we're going to come back to phrasal verbs later. If you've got any questions that you want to ask us about free time and hobbies and leisure activities, please post them in the comments and we'll put them on the screen to talk about. So I think our first question is from Naveen. Do you prefer to spend your free time alone or with other people? Kirk?
I like both, really. I mean, I need a little bit of time alone, just to sort of collect my thoughts and energize, I guess I would say. But I also really, you know, need to spend time with people, with friends, with family. I couldn't choose one or the other. What about you, Sally?
I'm kind of the same. I like, one of the things I really like doing is sketching. I like going around the city and also out in the countryside and sketching, and I really like doing that on my own, to be honest. But I love hanging out with people as well.
Okay.
My friends.
Sketching means drawing, right?
Yeah. So I draw with pen and sometimes with painting, sometimes paint as well. We had a question which I can't find out, it's disappeared, but somebody's asking what is hang gliding. Next question, but hang gliding.
Well, actually, I think we've got a picture of that coming up in a little while. I'll mention it, but it's a kind of like, well, how would you describe it, Sally? Like flying, no?
It's kind of like flying with a attached to a giant kite.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's a good description.
Okay, Monica says, what are the most popular free time activities where you live? What about where you are, Kirk?
Well, I mean, you know, we're so close to the sea. A lot of people go to the beach here. I'm more of a mountain person myself, so I do go to the beach. But actually, if you go to the mountains, you always find people hiking. So I'd say just getting outside, going to the beach or hiking are things that a lot of people do.
Yeah, it's definitely with the climate where in our part of the world, it's definitely a lot of outside activities, aren't there?
Yeah.
And I've noticed that now that the people can't go to the gym, there's a lot of people working out outside. I see a lot of people running. And there's also, I mean, there's a lot of, going to coffee shops, yeah? There's a lot of people sleeping. Oh, that's a good one. That's one of my favorite hobbies. Using social media, yeah. I mean, and people use social media a lot for learning English these days as well, don't they?
Tell us. Lots of really useful resources out there.
Okay. I think we've got, okay, Miguel says, have your hobbies changed over the years?
I would say some have and some haven't. But in general, I just don't have the time for hobbies that I had when I was younger, unfortunately. Someone says paragliding. Is hang gliding paragliding? I'm not sure what paragliding is. I think it might... paragliding's with a parachute, I think.
Are you sure?
We'll show up. No, I'm not sure. We'll show a picture of hang gliding in a little bit. I'm sorry, I don't know enough about hang gliding.
I would have to look that up in a dictionary, to be honest.
Yeah.
And actually, we were talking about dictionaries before, and I think we can put some links in for useful dictionaries if anybody's interested.
Yeah,
okay.
You know, I find a lot of my students, that's something they don't use the dictionary very much, and I would definitely recommend that to everyone, especially with phrasal verbs, because phrasal verbs have lots of different meanings, and it can get confusing if you don't use the dictionary.
That's true. Let's have a look at Manuel's question. Where do you like to go when you have free time?
Well, I would say I just like to be outside somewhere. I usually go into the mountains if I can, but really being outside in general is where I like to go. What about you, Sally, in your part of the city?
Well, I love being outside as well, and I love getting out of the city, to be honest. I do like living in Barcelona, but I like getting out of town.
Sure.
But I also really like going to art galleries.
Well, there's lots of those in Barcelona, no?
There are, and they're fantastic. Yeah. Okay, here's a question. I'm sorry, I can't read the script, but how do you like to spend your free time? Do you like to spend your free time with pets? That's a great question for me.
It is a good question. I actually don't have any pets, but
no
I
pets.
Did. I'm sure I would take them out with me, but I just don't have any.
So have you ever, because you've got three kids, you've got three children,
yeah.
You've never had any pets?
No. Never had a pet growing up and just never have enough with three kids.
Yeah, I can imagine. Okay, so I've got one child and one pet, which is a dog.
Uh-huh.
So I do spend a lot of time outside with my dog.
Oh, that's good.
So we go walking. Yeah. Okay. Tell us where you go with your pets, or what you do with your pets. We'd love to know. Okay, Maria Dolores says, has the pandemic made you discover new hobbies? That's a great question.
Yeah, I think I know a lot of people who've taken up new hobbies with the pandemic. I personally haven't taken up any new hobbies, but I have got into ones that I had before, but that I just didn't have time for. So
what was that thing you did? Didn't you start doing some DIY?
Yeah, some woodworking. just I like making things in general, and I have the tools to work with wood. So I made a workbench recently. So I don't know. I just enjoy it.
That's cool. I know some of my friends have taken up cooking, actually making naan bread. That seems to be a thing.
That sounds delicious, actually.
I love
naan bread, so that would be great.
Okay, here's another question.
I go out.
Yeah, do you want to read it, Kirk?
Yeah, I go out and I get out could have the same meaning. As I was mentioning before, phrasal verbs have lots of different meanings. So get out I would need to know a little bit more about the context to be able to say exactly what that means, because it can mean lots of different things here. I go out, I get out. It could possibly mean the same thing, Mary, in a very specific context, but it's really important to kind of know exactly what the context is or what your intention is when you use it. I'm sorry I can't answer that any better right now. I just need a little more information to be able to do that.
Maybe you could put the two verbs in sentences in context and put them into the chat, and everyone else can say what they think as well.
Good idea.
Ah, look, Maggie says, yeah, I started reading and playing piano during the pandemic. Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, that's
and did you teach yourself the piano?
Yeah, really.
I used to have a dog when I was 6 years old. Oh, and I spent a lot of time with my dog, I guess. Mm. That's great.
It is great.
Okay, thanks for all your questions. Okay, somebody's... Violetta's saying paragliding is with a paraglider and hang gliding is with hang glider. Okay. That makes sense.
So they are different then.
That makes sense.
Yeah, thank you for that.
do you think we should move on? So I think we've got
a quiz, yeah.
Yeah, you've got a top tip, haven't you?
That's right. Thanks, Sally.
Get your top tip.
Yeah. Well, actually, this kind of came up in the questions and answers. I just wanted to encourage everyone to remember that phrasal verbs have several different meanings. I mean, often they have quite a lot of different meanings. So if you hear or read a phrasal verb being used in a way that doesn't make sense to you, probably it has a meaning that you didn't know about. So it's really important to look the phrasal verb up in a good dictionary. There are lots of good online dictionaries that available to everyone. We'll put some of those. All right, there's some links to different dictionaries you can use in the comments. And you know, when you find a new phrasal verb, I would focus on trying to understand it first, or understand the different meanings first. Later on, you can start using it. But in the beginning, since there are often different meanings, I would just focus on understanding them first.
Okay, great. That's really useful, that tip. I'm just seeing in the comments people asking about improving their fluency in speaking. And I think we can put links to some activities from our British Council websites there. There's some really good ones on Learn English Teens that I use for improving speaking and fluency. Okay. Yeah. I was just going to summarize what we've done today.
Great.
And then we're going to move on to the next part. But just to summarise, so today we've talked about free time and hobbies. We've learned six phrasal verbs from Kirk. We've answered lots of your questions, and Kirk shared his top tip. Now we're going to have a quiz. Is that right?
Yes, a short quiz for all of you. So it's a multiple choice quiz. You just choose the correct answer, and please let us know what you think the answers are in the chat. So we can go to the first question already, which should come up on the screen here. Very good. So I'll read it out to you. Faisal is lots of Spanish from watching Mexican films. It's amazing. So Faisal is working out, picking up, or taking up. Let us know what you think the correct answer is. Working out, picking up, or taking up. Please let us know in the chat. And I'll put the answers at the end.
Yeah.
All right, so we can move on to the second question.
I can see answers coming in for this one already. That's great. Ah, here's the picture of the hang glider.
Ah, yes, this is the picture I was thinking of. So this is question number two. Anna has recently hang gliding. She loves it. So is it A, got into, B, worked out, or C, gone out? So got into, worked out, or gone out? Let us know what you think the answer is in the chat. Yeah, and I'll be telling you the answers in just a moment. We have one more question, though, first.
Okay, lots of answers coming in. Great.
There's loads of answers. That's good. It looks like lots of people, like you said, Sally, I think maybe this was a little too easy for most people. There's lots of correct answers there. So very good. I'm glad to see that. Well, let's go on to the third and final question in the quiz. Now, this one is a little different. Be careful. There's here you're choosing the answer that is not correct, all right? Not correct. Which one of these definitions of to work out is not correct? A, to calculate a number. B, to work in the garden. And C, to exercise. One of those definitions is not correct. So let us know which one you think it is. All right, so we'll just wait for just a moment to see the answers come through for this last one. All right, thanks awesome. Everyone.
Thank you.
All right, well, let's go on to the answers then. We've got the answers coming up in just a moment here. All right, so for number one, the correct answer was B. Picking up. Remember, to pick up means to learn by watching or listening. So Faisal is picking up Spanish from watching Mexican films. In number two, it's got into. It means to become interested in. So Anna has really gotten in or got into hang gliding recently. And number three, the definition that is not correct for to work out is to work in the garden. Workout means to exercise or to calculate a number. Actually, it has other meanings as well, but it doesn't mean to work in the garden.
Okay, brilliant. Thanks, Kirk. I think that was a really good quiz. And it's always good to have a reminder, isn't it? A revision. Even if it's some language item that you think you're familiar with, it's always good to have a revision and to practice using it again. So well done if you got them all right, and well done if you took part. And I hope that was useful for you. We've run out of time, haven't we?
I think we have, yeah.
So we're gonna wrap up now. I just want to say, I just want to remind you that if you go to our websites, our British Council websites, you'll find lots of information about phrasal verbs there. There's the on Learn English and then Learn English Teens. And I know there's some teachers watching as well, because I've seen comments from teachers. And I just had a quick look today on the Teaching English website, and there's a few lesson plans there and lesson activities based on phrasal verbs as well.
That's right.
Thank you everyone for joining us, and thanks for taking part. And please join us again next month, where we've got a session with Jenny and Jonathan, who are talking about writing emails. I think that'll be really, really useful. And then we've got another live lesson all about the world of work and jobs. So hopefully see you then. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.